In August, Parliament adopted a report by the Committee on Tourism, Trade and Industry recommending the dismissal of the accounting officer of the Minister of Trade, Geraldine Sally, on account of alleged procurement flaws, misappropriation of funds meant for renovation works of the ministry's offices at Farmers House. Early this month, the Secretary to the Treasury, Ramadan Gobi, hit to Parliament's recommendation and dropped Sally as an accounting officer and replaced her with Alfred Andima, the Under-Secretary Finance and Administration at the Ministry. In a bizarre development, President Yoweri Museveni has issued a directive to the Secretary to the Treasury to reinstate Sally as the accounting officer of the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives, almost a month after she was dropped from that position over a 8.2 billion shillings scandal.
We did our work, investigated, came up with a report involving the 6.2 billion that was misused, money that was meant for the renovation of Farmer's House. And in our recommendations, it was clear that Geraldine Sally was involved in massive corruption, massive fraud, and we recommended that she should be removed from being an accounting officer of the Minister of Trade.
The later directing the Permanent Secretary and Secretary to the Treasury, Ramadan Gobi, to reinstate Sally is dated 22nd October 2023, signed by Lucy Nachobe, the Head of Public Service and Secretary to the Cabinet. This has sparked anger from members of Parliament, claiming that the decision of the President is to ridicule Parliament.
By thinking he's ridiculing Parliament. Because when people take serious investigations like those ones, the best thing you can do as a head of state or as a chief executive is to respect them. Where have they erred? You should bring out where the committee erred.
Lawmakers have questioned the president's commitment to fight corruption if he continues to trust officials implicated in corruption with public funds. However, some lawmakers have sided with the president, saying Sally was witch-hunted by mafias who are behind shifting of the ministry from Farmer's House, where they pay 142 million shillings for rent annually, to new premises that require 5 billion shillings rental fees. They argue that she saved public funds when she rejected relocation of the ministry offices.
You will see that Geraldine Sally, her intention is, we are not to defraud Ugandans. We are not to divert the money. But the intention was very good because she wanted to save Ugandans. She wanted to save money. You could not go and rent at the cost of 80 billion plus and you leave your own building where you are. Actually, they have been examined the building and confirmed that it can stay for more than 100 years.
It's now becoming a common phenomenon for Parliament to make recommendations and they are thwarted by Cabinet. For example, in March, Parliament adopted a report of the Select Committee, which investigated mismanagement at NSSF, with a recommendation for the Minister of Gender, Betty Yamongi, to resign with immediate effect, which never happened. Still, Parliament censored the State Minister of Housing, Persis Namganza, in January this year, but the minister has never been fired by the appointing authority. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.